In the previous session, we have discussed about how to install Selenium WebDriver and what are the problems we have faced with Selenium WebDriver, and we have just did a small login scenario. Before that, before we move to the next step, we want to understand how exactly automation works. How exactly automation works. Imagine that I have a website. We are going to start learning about automation. Imagine that I have a website. I have a website called abc.com. I have username text box. I have password box. I have a login button. I have username text box, I have password box, and I have a login button. I need to login into this application. How can I login into the application? First, I need to open browser. Then I need to open the URL called abc.com. Enter the username in the username text box. Enter the password in the password box, then click on login. After entering the username and password, after opening the browser and URL, if I want to enter the username in the username text box, first I need to identify this username text box and perform some typing operation. Then I need to identify this password box, perform some typing operation. If I want to click on this login button, identify this element and perform some click operation. To do any sort of automation, we'll be doing only two steps. One is identifying the element. Second one is performing action on it. These are the only two steps what we will be doing. For example, if I have a checkbox, I need to identify this element and I need to perform action. If I have a radio button, if I want to click on the radio button, first I need to identify the radio button and I need to perform action on it. If I have a link called forget your password link, first I need to identify this element, then I need to perform action on it. To do any sort of automation, we'll be doing only two steps. One is identifying the element, the other one is performing action on the element. Right? To identify the elements, we will use element locators. To identify, we have eight different ways how to identify the element. ID, name, link text. Wait. Mute your microphone. Who is that? Link text, XPath, CSS selector, class name, tag name, partial, link text. These are the eight element locators available in Selenium. ID, name, link text, XPath, CSS selector, class name, tag name, and partial link text. Either I can use ID to identify this. First, right click, inspect, and see the source code of that element. If you have ID, you can go with ID, or else you can go with name, or else with link text. Likewise, you have to keep on identifying the elements. With the elements, whatever we identify, we need to perform action. Now, as a first step, what I am going to do, I am going to open the browser, open the URL called demo.actitime.com. Then, after opening the URL called demo.actitime.com, I need to enter admin, I need to enter manager, and I need to click on login. These are the steps what I have to do. open the browser, open the URL, enter username in the username text box, enter password in the password box, then click on login button. Then click on login button. These are the steps what I have to do. Now, this is the code how to open the browser and URL. WebDriver driver equal to new Firefox driver is to open the browser. Driver.get method. Get method is used to open the URL. Get method is used to open the URL. I have opened the browser and I have opened the URL also. If I run this, it will open the browser and URL. No doubt with that. After opening the browser and URL, I want to enter the username in the username text box. I need to enter the username in the username text box. Open the browser, open the URL called demo.actitime.com. That's it. Next, my goal is to enter the username in the username text box. In that class, I have to do right click inspect. See the source code of that element. See the source code of this element. This is the source code. In this source code, do you have ID? I want to identify based on this order. In this order, if you have ID, I can go with ID. First, identify the element. Yes, it has ID. ID equal to username. With that ID equal to username, I can start identifying the elements here. Driver dot find element is used to find the element. Driver dot find element is used to find the element. This find element method takes by-class arguments. This find element method takes by-class arguments and this returns a web element. This find element method, what does it takes? It takes by-class arguments. The input of this method is by-class arguments and this returns a web element. Find element method, this takes by-class arguments and this returns a web element. Since it takes by-class arguments, by dot ID. See, as I said, this find element method takes by class arguments and this returns a web element. Since it returns a web element, I have to hold that in a web element variable un. un dot send keys admin. See, I have identified that element. By using driver.findElement. This findElement method takes by-class arguments. And this returns a web element. Since it takes by-class arguments, I have given by dot. And since this returns a web element, I am holding that in a web element. Un dot. Send keys is used to type. UN dot send keys is for typing. I am going to type as admin. Send keys. I am identifying the element in one line and performing action. Whatever the element I have identified, I am holding that in a web element variable, UN. Open the browser, open the URL. demo.actitime.com, enter admin. That's it, done. Next, after opening browser, I need to enter the username in the username text box. Done. Then I need to enter password in the password box. Right click, inspect. Password in the password box. Name equal to pwd. Driver dot find element by dot See here, all the elements are located in alphabetical order, but don't go with this order. See, when I do right click, when I want to identify this element, I do right click and inspect. First, there is a type attribute, name attribute, class attribute, placeholder attribute, but there is no ID attribute. As per my assumption, first I want to go with ID. There is no ID. That's why I went to name. Is there a name for this element? Yes, I have name. In that case, I can use name equal to PWD and start identifying the element. Driver.findElementById. There is no ID. If you have ID, go with ID, or else go with name. PWD. It returns a web element. Hold that in a web element variable. Web element PW. On that PW dot send keys manager. Manager. Done. Then I need to click on this login button. I need to click on this login button, right click, inspect. I need to identify this login button. How to identify this login button? Driver dot find element by dot ID equal to login button. This returns a web element. Since this returns a web element, driver dot find element is used to identify the button. Identify any element. I have identified that element. Since that returns a web element, I am holding that in a web element variable. Button dot click. That's it. If I run this, open the browser, it will open the URL. Open the URL called demo.actytime.com. Enter admin manager, click on login so that you will be able to log in into the application. Yes, done. The same program, whatever I have written this in a different way. Take down this into your notes. I will explain what is the difference between the previous one and this one, which one to use best, all those things. Just take down this into your notes. Make it quick. Whenever I tell you to take down the program, take down which is there inside the main method. No need to take down this import statements and all. Why? Because already I have said you in yesterday's class that how to get the import statements automatically. I hope everyone have completed. What is this driver dot find element? This is equal to un. This driver dot find element by dot id equal to username. This is equal to un. Un dot send keys. That is what I have used. See what I am. Un is nothing but driver dot find element. Whatever I have selected here, this is equal to un. Right click. I am going to cut this and paste it instead of un and paste it instead of un, so that whatever you have written in two lines, I have written that in one line, holding that in a variable and using it. Then that directly I am using, this is nothing but un dot send keys I am using. Either you can use in that way or else you can use in this way. What is this driver dot find element by id equal to by name equal to pwd? This is equal to pw dot send keys manager. Next, driver dot find element by id equal to login button. Driver dot find element by id equal to login button dot click. I am going to click. Then writing that in two different lines, I am writing that in one line. Then it will login into the application. Open the browser, open the URL. Manager, click on login. Login. Then click on. That's it. This is all about how to login into the application. Now, I have opened the browser, opened the URL, I have entered admin manager and I have clicked on login. After logging in, I need to click on this logout link as well. I have entered admin manager, clicked on login. After logging in, I need to click on logout. I need to click on logout. How to click on logout? Right click. Inspect. Logout. Driver dot find element by dot id equal to logout link by id equal to logout link dot click. I am going to click on that. That's it. Driver dot find element by id equal to log. First I am logging in, then I am clicking on logout. Everything is perfect, but when I run this, see here what happens. It opens the browser. It will open the URL called demo.actytime.com. demo.actitime.com. Enter admin manager, click on login. After logging in, it is throwing an error. It is not clicking on logout. It is trying to click on logout, but it didn't find. That's why it has clicked on. It has thrown an error. Why? What is the reason? Because it is taking some time to load the page. After entering admin and manager, it is taking some time to load the page in between this. It is trying to enter admin manager, click on login. Admin manager, click on login. After logging in, then I need to wait for some time, some 10, 15 seconds or 20 seconds. I need to wait. Then only I need to click on logout. Thread dot sleep for some 20 seconds. I am going to give. Click on this. Click on add throws. Thread or sleep. Then open the browser, open the URL. demo.actitime.com. admin manager, click on login. After logging in, I need to wait for 20 seconds. I need to wait for 20 seconds. Then after 20 seconds, it will click on logout. See here, after 20 seconds, then it will click on logout. Yes, it has clicked on logout. But the page is getting loaded in 7 to 8 seconds. The remaining 12 to 13 seconds, it is wasting the time here. We are doing automation to save time. See, this thread.sleep, it will hold the execution. If you use this thread.sleep, it will take milliseconds. Thread.sleep, it will take milliseconds. Long milliseconds. I am going to give 20,000 milliseconds, which is 20 seconds. But when it gives thread or sleep, it throws an exception like this. Click on this and click on this add throws. That's it. Click on this and go with click on add throws. That's it. Now, after logging in, I am giving some extra time here, but the page is getting loaded. If I reduce this time, if internet is slow, then it will throw you an error. That's why I have given here extra time. But this is not the good way to do. As soon as you log in, you have to click on logout and you have to proceed further. Open the browser, open the URL, it will click on login and then it will click on logout. It will do. Last time also it has did perfectly. Take down login and logout program and take down this. Next we will move to the next step. Have you completed everyone? Can you please unmute and reply me, any one of them, please? Yes, okay. Okay. Now, what we have to do here is, okay, let me tell you the next test case. First, I need to open the browser, open the URL called demo.activetime.com, open the browser, open the URL called demo.activetime.com, then I have to give a wrong username, I have to give a wrong username as Pratap, I have to give a wrong username, clear that wrong username. Then give the correct username. Then give the correct username as admin and correct password as manager. Then click on login. These are the steps what we have to do. These are the steps what we have to do. Okay. First, let me explain you once again. First, open the browser, open the URL, give a wrong username. Give a wrong username. Give a wrong username. Clear this wrong username. Clear this wrong username. Then enter the correct username, correct password. Then I need to click on login. Then I need to click on login. These are the steps what I have to do. These are the steps what I have to do. In this case, I am coming to know how to clear. Right click, new class, demo, clear, static void main, finish. Web driver, driver equal to new Firefox driver. Web driver, driver equal to new Firefox driver. Driver dot get and open the URL, driver.get and open the URL. I have opened the browser and I have opened the URL. I have opened the browser and I have opened the URL. Then I need to identify this element, right click, inspect. I need to identify this element. I need to identify this element, then I need to give a wrong username. In that case, how I can do? Driver dot find element. Find element is used to find the element. Find element by dot id equal to username dot send keys Pratap. I've given a wrong username. Then after typing Pratap, I need to clear that. How to do that? Driver dot find element by dot ID equal to username. I have identified that element and I am going to use dot clear so that it will clear. Run this. Open the browser, open the URL demo.activetime.com. Type Pratap and clear. It has typed Pratap and it has cleared. It is doing very quickly. If you want to see the execution slowly, then let me use thread.sleep for some 3 seconds. Let me run this. It has opened the browser, it has opened the URL demo.activetime.com. Then type Pratap, clear that Pratap. Done. Yeah. Yeah, tell me, Zain. Mm-hmm. That's why that we will see. The next coming classes we are going to see that. After typing wrong username, I'll click on this login so that I'll be getting some text here telling that please enter correct username and password. Enter valid credentials or something. User password is invalid. We have to validate this text. How to validate these things, that we'll see in the upcoming chapters.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. See, those things are last classes, what you are asking. You have to wait for a few days. First, we have to come to know how to automate any elements, whatever we find in a web page. Okay, first let us go with the basics, then we can go with those advanced things, whatever you are asking. Okay then. Then, I need to enter the correct username. Then, how to do that? Driver dot, find element, by dot, id equal to username dot, send keys, admin. Right click, inspect. Now, driver dot find element by dot name equal to pwd dot send keys manager. Then click on login. I need to click on login. How to click on login? Inspect. I have a ID equal to login button. Then how to do the driver dot find element by dot ID equal to login button dot click. Login button dot click. Sit. Run this. See here. Now it is opening the browser, then it will open the URL called demo.actitime.com. Then give a wrong username. Clear that wrong username, then give the correct username, correct password, click on login. So that it will login into the application. In this case, we came to know how to clear the statement. That's it. What you can do is you can take down this. Can take down this program. Make it quick, guys. Next, we'll see the next chapter. We will be entering into the core topics. This is just the installation and basic program in Selenium WebDriver. Next, we will be moving in depth. Okay, done. Next. Okay, guys. Just a small thing today. Since it's raining heavily here, I am dropping off today's class by this. Next, we will have on Monday.